penitent one. Our bond led us to victory. But it was not the victory I long for. Is it your wish that I continue with the story of my promise? Indeed. It was the miracle's will that made the bell ring. But it was the Lady's sin that brought the curse down upon us. The Lady. The most beautiful of women, who lived in the palace by the lake, lived to admire her own beauty, which she believed to be unnaturally divine. The reflection of the lake in which she admired herself returned her own beauty with yet more intensity and splendor, keeping her spellbound for days. Desiring that reflected perfection for herself, she prayed to the lake that no one else might see that reflection. As she looked at her reflection one more time, she saw her face distort to the sound of a terrible tolling that rose up from the lake's sunken bell. Do you wish me to join you in your... There you shall find me. And in communion, we shall fight.
How dark and uncertain are the rooms where the miracle allows us to see and talk to one another. Even after the deaths. Even after the dreams. Penitent one, we are in the Chapel of the Five Doves, and before you prevails the narrative voice of the Witness. All that remains of me is testimony, for my deceased body lies exposed in its urn of crystal and gold. You return from the long dream to avoid the birth. You will have need of the uncorrupted tongue that my mortal remains still harbor, whose forbidden whispers will guide thee on the path to such an undertaking. Release the five doves, and thus the urn containing my body shall be opened. Wake up now from this dream.